Yes, I admit, the word sounds pretty cool. Disruption. It is a term that is often used in connection with innovation. Disruptive innovation. But what exactly is disruptive innovation? Is disruptive innovation the same as radical innovation? That's exactly what this video is about. To say it right away, anyone who equates disruptive innovation with radical innovation is mixing up two very different ways of categorizing innovation. Let's briefly repeat how I explained radical innovation in the video, What is Innovation? When we innovate to solve a problem, we can do so in two ways. We can either improve an existing solution step by step, then we speak of incremental innovation. Or we may set out in search of a completely new solution to the problem, thanks to new knowledge or new technology, and then we speak of radical innovation. Radical comes from the Latin word radix and means root. A radical innovation goes to the root of a problem and looks for new ways to solve it. Whether an innovation is incremental or radical, whether it is built on an existing solution or in completely new ways, says nothing about whether it will have a significant impact on an industry and its suppliers and customers. In other words, it provides no information about whether or not a market will be destroyed, in other words, disrupted by an innovation. When we talk about disruptive innovation, on the other hand, we are making a statement about how an innovation affects the market and its participants. And not about whether it solves a problem with an improved or completely new product. However, there is more to the term disruption or disruptive innovation than simply stating that it is turning an industry on its head. There is a pattern behind it that can be used strategically. The term disruption goes back to Clayton Christensen. He noticed that established and successful companies increasingly focused their development on affluent customers or the upper market segments. As a result, they produce ever better, higher quality, but also more expensive products that meet and often exceed the needs of the upper market segment. A bathroom scale, for example, that measures body weight to 5 decimal places is objectively more accurate than one that only measures to 2 decimal places. But for the overwhelming majority of customers, this higher accuracy is useless. Christensen went on to describe how the market of an industry can be changed bottom up. If an innovation is launched that performs significantly worse in the features dominated by the market-leading companies, but has another feature that is valued in the neglected lower market segments or by less affluent customers, then this new offering slowly begins to gain market share from below. Let's stay with the hypothetical example of the bathroom scale for a moment. Let's assume that a manufacturer launches a paper-thin scale that folds up to the size of a credit card and is very inexpensive, but can only display the kilogram value without decimal places. This product would be far inferior to the established solutions in terms of measurement accuracy. However, it could compete with the cheapest alternatives in the market in terms of price and would be unrivaled in terms of size, space requirements, and portability. Clayton Christensen has observed that the established companies hardly feel threatened by such innovations. Firstly, because the new solutions are aimed at a market segment that is unattractive to them. And secondly, because they are significantly inferior to their own offerings in the features that are considered important. Things get interesting when the innovation slowly but surely improves in the supposedly important features. As a result, it gains more and more customers from the upper market segment and suddenly becomes a serious competitor for the established providers. Under certain circumstances, the incumbents may even be pushed out of the market altogether and the market is disrupted. Textbook examples are the digital camera, which destroyed the market for analog cameras, or MP3, which destroyed the market for CDs, and there are countless others. Christensen also described disruption from top down. The pattern is very similar, but here a solution is introduced that is so expansive and so exclusive that only a very small part of the market can be considered as customers. The established companies do not feel threatened here either, as they do not assume that the customer group can become larger. Disruption occurs when the new luxury solution becomes more affordable. The prime example of this is Tesla. The first model, the Roadster, was only affordable for the rich. But this model established Tesla as cool, as the dream car of the tech elite. As the subsequent models became more and more affordable, more and more people wanted to be part of this automotive avant-garde and bought a Tesla. How can this understanding of the nature of disruption be strategically helpful? It invites companies to ask themselves what a new solution could look like for the lower, unattractive market or for the top 1% of the most affluent target group. Which features should be deliberately omitted? Which features should be prioritized instead? And do you see an opportunity to penetrate the mass market bottom-up or top-down over time? To summarize, radical innovation and disruptive innovation are not the same thing. While radical innovation is concerned with creating a new solution to a problem, disruption is concerned with considering the characteristics of the solution that could disrupt and take over existing markets. An innovation can be both at the same time or not. Anyone who lumps radical innovation and disruptive innovation into the same category is missing out on the opportunity to explore the strategically exciting patterns behind disruption and to take advantage of the resulting questions. Innovation Booster supports the search for radical innovations, for new ways to solve a problem. Whether this new solution has what it takes to be disruptive is a strategic question that can be incorporated into the design, but will ultimately only be answered by the market. With this in mind, stay innovative and strategic.